Hello, good morning. Now we'll continue with the classification of salient strata. We have done two classes, that is class Hydrozoa and class Scyphozoa. Now, salient strata, in a nutshell, you can say they are aquatic marine animals. They show tissue level of organization. The mouth is present, which is encircled by thin short tentacles. It is diploblastic, having two layers, ectoderm and endoderm. It is acoelomate animal. It shows blind body plan, sac plan. It has got non-cellular layer of mesoglia between the two layers. It has specialized cells known as nidoblast, which are the stinging cells. It shows radial symmetry. And inside the body, it has a hollow cavity called cilientron. Mode of reproduction is asexual by budding and sexual with the help of the sex cells, which forms ciliated free swimming larva. Nutrition is holozoic in the case of cilientrates, and there is no anus present in the organism, and mouth is responsible for both ingestion and elimination. The cilientrates, they show two important forms. One is the asexual form, which is known as polyp, and second is medusa, which is the sexual form. Now we'll start with the anthozoa. The anthozoa, they are exclusively marine organism, and they are divided into different orders. The order Stolonifera with organism Tubipora. Second order is Alcyonacea with example Alcyonium. Third order is Actiniaria with example Metridium. Fourth example is Zoanthidia with example Zoanthus. And the fifth order is Madreporaria with example Fungia, Fabia, Madrepora and Astrangia. So one by one we'll take all the examples. Now first is Tubipora. Tubipora is commonly known as organ pipe coral. It is elongated polyp, lies parallel to each other with their internal skeleton made up of fused spicules. From mesoglia form erect parallel tubes which arise from a basal plate and are joined by calcareous platforms. The polyps lie in the tubes, partly projecting above. The polyps are green and the skeleton is a dark red due to the iron salts. Tubipora is widely distributed on the coral reefs. Second example is Alcyonium. It is dead man fingers or soft coral. They are found mainly in temperate and cold sea, Atlantic water. On the North American coast, it is marine, sedentary in nature. The animal is found on the littoral zone and tidal zone. The body is diploblastic. Mesoglia has spicules throughout, thus providing strength to the cenchyme. Body is divided into base, stalk and lobes, which are huge and fleshy because of the presence of mesoglial cenchyme. Body consists of polyps, which resembles the shape of a star. Then it is known as anthocoidea. Next example is Metridium. Metridium has a short cylindrical body, about 8 cm in length. The body is radially spherical and is divisible into three distinct regions, that is oral disc, column and basal disc. The upper free end is flat circular oral disc or peristome, having a large oval mouth on the slight elevation. Around the mouth is numerous short conical and hollow tentacles in 5 circles or cycles. Generally, each cycle has tentacles in multiple of 6, The number of tentacle increases with the age. The tentacles are very sensitive to chemical stimulation by food juices. Tentacles bear numerous nematocysts. Next example is Zoanthus. Zoanthus has small cylindrical elongated polyp which arise singly from network of stolon, which is a horizontal branch. The polyp has two distinct part, the oral disc and the cylindrical column. The pedal disc is absent. The oral disc bear a central mouth surrounded by unbranched numerous 48 to 60 tentacles. The tentacles are usually arranged in one or two circles. There is only a single ventral siphonoglyph. Sexes, they are separate. Asexual reproduction takes place with the help of budding. Zoanthus is usually found in epizoic in West Indies. Next example is Fungia. Fungia is commonly known as mushroom coral and it is solitary, found in warm seas, usually in Gulf of California. The mushroom coral is a large size with a discoidal coralite, convex on the upper and concave on the lower surface. The septa are numerous and connected together by septicula. Theca is present only at the lower surface. Adult animal bears a single large polyp with the many tentacles. Siphonoglyph absent. Reproduction resembles more or less by transverse fission. Next example is Favia. The colonies are massive, rounded or flat. Corallites are conical. Septa are slightly irregular and widely spaced. Pelliform lobes are poorly developed. Closely placed polygonal cups bearing polyps, they are present. Theca are so close together as to have common walls. The synenchyme is formed by calcification of synosarc and give origin to the individual corallites. Next example is Madrepora. The Madrepora, commonly known as horn coral, is colonial, found in Australian Sea. Colony is branched with small polyps in the cylindrical cups, separated by perforated synostium. Terminal polyps bear 6 end tentacles, while the lateral polyps bear 12 tentacles. Mesenteries are bilaterally arranged. The Madrepora is economically important because it takes place in the part in the formation of coral reefs. Next example is Astringia. It forms small stony coral. It is not a reef building coral. The polyps are distinct. They are usually white, pinkish or greenish. It feeds on small animals like algae, protozoa, worms and small fishes. Each polyp secretes a calcareous cup-like skeleton called corallite within which the animal rests. Next example is Estria. It is a massive stony coral found on the coast of warm seas. The colony comprises numerously closely fitted polygonal cups or theci. Theci are so close to each other as to have the common walls. The skeleton is very hard, made up of calcium carbonate, and is secreted by the ectoderm for the support of the delicate tissues. The colony is formed by the buds. The synenchyme is produced by the calcification of synosarc and also gives rise to corallite, which lies in close contact to each other. Next example is Gorgonia. It belongs to order Gorgoniaceae. Gorgonia is commonly known as sea fan. It forms large, upright, lattice-like branching colony of yellow or red color. The colony is fixed by basal plate, from which the branches arise in the one plane. The branches bear cylinder polyps with 8 pinnate tentacles. The skeleton is not calcareous, but it is made up of horny protein called gorgonin, around which the mesoglea forms calcareous spicules. The skeleton is secreted by the outer surface of animal but it appears internal. Within the mesoglea is a network of branching tubes called solenia, which are tubular extensions of external carrying water, oxygen and food. The sexes in the colony are separate. Sea fan flourish in shallow tropical sea, forming giant plant-like groups. And last example is Penetula. It belongs to order Penetulacea. It is also known as sea pen. It forms quail-like bilaterally symmetrical colony, which looks like a fern frond. The central stem is a huge axial polyp. It has lower peduncle and a distal rachis. The stem contains an unbranched horny skeletal rod, an external cavity and mesoglea within which are solenia as tubular extensions of the anteron. The peduncle is buried in the sea mud by enlarged and bulb by peristaltic contraction of the peduncle, sea pen. It can burrow in the mud and even change its position. Calcareous spicules in the mesoglea. There is no axis in the branches. Penetula has a bright orange-red color. It is found in the warm coast of Atlantic and Pacific Ocean. So these are the examples belonging to the order Penetulacea. Now, with this, we finish the class Anthozoa.